Today in the news, we've got some interesting Intel products, some water cooling news, and a monitor I can't afford. What's up, guys? I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Let's get started with Intel. They had quite a lot to show during Computex, and actually, some of it is quite interesting. First is their new successor to the M10 Optane Memory. These were the caching sticks that were revealed last year. I've never been a fan of the solution, but nonetheless, we have an upgrade. The main change here is the use of 4 lanes of PCIe 3.0 to upgrade the speeds to 2000 megabytes read and 900 writes, compared to 1450 read and 650 write respectively on their older models. Then they announced their Nook compute elements. These are quite interesting little cards. They contain a CPU, memory, and storage, and they're kind of like barebone systems on a card for various uses. You could plug them into a vending machine, an appliance, or even a notebook, and it would basically run as a PC. They make use of Intel's U series of processors, so you could get some pretty mid-range performance out of that. It's almost like you could buy a shell for a notebook and upgrade it by switching up the cards, although I highly doubt that this is Intel's main use case. These will land in the first half of next year, and I'm curious to see where they're going to implement them. At their booth, they also showcased an OLED bar that is integrated into the touchpad. This little sliver of screen would allow you to see some notifications, battery levels, or even prompt a digital assistant. Correct me if I'm wrong, but didn't the company try to do that in the early 2000s? I know it was a thing in smartphones with the edge displays, but I'm sure that I saw it on a laptop. Anyways, it's pretty surprising to see an edge display these days, not because it's cool, but more because it's kind of useless on the laptop. If your laptop isn't open, you're not really looking at it, and when it's open, it's going to be covered up by your palms or just not in use. As for the digital assistant part of it, I mean, we all have a phone, right? What do you guys think about this? Let me know down below. And lastly, for Intel, a very, very strange prototype of a gaming laptop was showcased at their booth. It's a top-down dual-screen gaming laptop with different aspect ratios. Actually, it reminds me a bit of that HP Omen laptop we saw a few days ago. Instead, now, the second screen is actually usable. Asus also unveiled their ZenBook Pro Duo with 2 screens, but once again, the second screen is kind of flat with the keyboard, making it, in my opinion, not that great. Going back to Intel's prototype though, this gaming laptop has a dual hinge design where both screens are on separate planes. This allows for much better use of the second extremely wide bottom display. I still don't really like the design since the keyboard and the touchpad space seem super cramped, especially for gaming, but I do see how something like this could be great for on-the-go streamers. The top could be used for the actual game and the bottom for social media and interacting with the viewers. On the show floor, that model sports an 8-core 9th Gen H series processor with a GTX 1070. The 8-core processor doesn't have a 4-digit number. There's also a Tobii Eye tracker in the hinge, which could be useful in some ways. Apparently, the laptop was thrown together with off-the-shelf parts. The bottom display actually comes straight out of a screen used in car displays. What do you guys think about this design? Let me know down below. In cooling news, Corsair just decided to enter the DIY open-loop liquid cooling market. Their new Hydro X series contains radiators, fittings, reservoirs, liquids, GPUs, and CPU blocks. It's a pretty impressive jump from a company known for its AIOs, but it's mostly thanks to EK water blocks since most of their parts are manufactured by them. At least they changed the designs of most parts so it doesn't look like a rebadge. As usual, Corsair really RGB'd the hell out of this lineup. Also in Corsair, or should I say Elgato news, the Stream Deck line just got bigger. We now have 3 sizes to choose from, a 6, 15, and now a brand new Stream Deck XL with 32 buttons. The more the buttons, the better in my opinion, and 32 looks pretty appealing to me. Imagine all the macros you could set. Let's just hope it's not gonna be like $600. And lastly, in monitor news, Asus just announced their mini LED ROG Swift monitor. Now you heard me right, it's not a micro LED panel, but a mini LED backlight. Basically, this monitor allows for 576 dimming zones for a pretty fine-tuned HDR experience, although it's nowhere near OLED, but for gaming, it's pretty cool. In true ROG fashion, it will be an overclockable panel that goes up to 144Hz. And did I mention it's a 4K monitor? Yeah, this guy will probably cost you an arm and a good chunk of your leg. Anyways guys, that is pretty much it for the news today. Hopefully you've enjoyed today's stories. If you have any questions, put them down below. Don't forget to leave a like if you liked it, and you can click right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel. Stay frosty my dudes, and I'll see you on the next one. What's happening today? I can't speak. Shirley sells some seashells down the seashore. Of course, I'll buy a couple of them.